Alrighty, welcome back everyone, it's Garland here bringing you another Neverwinter video, and today we're going to release the full build and guide for the Anointed Champion, Devoted Cleric, for Mod 11. Now as always, disclaimer, this is how I choose to build my character. It does work very well, however, like I've said before, there are many ways to build the DC, to each is their own. You can do many things with the DC. You can buff debuff, you can strictly buff, you can be a healing DC if you so choose, you can be a DPS DC if you so choose, which will be better when they release the DC changes, which they did release the patch notes for the DC upcoming DC changes that I believe went live on PC today, which is the 16th of March of 2017. The DC changes, I believe, did go live today on PC. So once those changes do come to Xbox, you know, we will do some workarounds with the DC. But for right now on console, this is still my current setup. So let's begin here. Like I said, you know, full disclosure, this is just the way that I do it. I got a lot of heat for putting out my guide for the build. A lot of people didn't like it. You know, they gave me a lot of negative feedback. And I just don't know if they just didn't try it or they don't want to listen. But hey, whatever. You know, I can only give you guys the information. What you do with it, and that's up to you. But let's begin here. So for your races, I would strongly suggest going Dragonborn for the 3% power. If you don't have access to Dragonborn, Human is probably your next best option to go with. Overall, you can pick whatever race you want. I mean, it's your character. So, Dragonborn is definitely going to be best in slot for the DC, just for the 3% power increase, followed by the Human, in my eyes at least. If we look at the statistics real quick here, ideally, you would like to actually max your intelligence and your charisma. However, I went with the wisdom just because my AP gain is already high enough that, you know, you can basically do what you want. If you want to max out each, you know, one of these or three, you know, two of these, whatever, just pick the two that you want. I went with wisdom just for the damage bonus for when I'm actually soloing dailies. But ideally, it would be best to go intelligence and charisma for this build. That way, you know, for intelligence, your recharge speed is increased. And your charisma is going to recharge speed increase and your AP gain increase. So your statistics will be up to you. Like I said, for this build, ideally, you want to go intelligence and charisma. However, if you do want the wisdom, if you're playing a healing DC, well then yes, you would obviously want the wisdom. But that's just some of the statistics there. Let's look at the feats just really quickly. I'm not going to go over the feats fully because I did release the build itself. I will leave a link in the description to the build, but if you guys want, just take a glance and pause the video if you so choose. And this is the current setup. Like I said, I'm not going to go into details about this as I already did put out a video on the build itself. So go ahead and take a look at this. Like I said, I'll leave a link in the description for you guys. I'm not going to go over the boons because they should be pretty much self-explanatory. And plus, I don't have all of the boons on my DC. You know, like, this is a work in progress character. I was hesitant to even releasing this video, but I get spammed every single day. You guys want the full build and the full guide for the DC, so I'm going to put it out there, even though mine isn't complete. I'm missing Tyranny of Dragons. What else here? An Icewind Dale. I'm basically going to buy Icewind Dale and Tyranny whenever there's a sale. I'm not paying full price for it. And then I never finished Elemental Evil, and I'm working on the Maze Engine. So yeah, I gotta do that. Now for your Stronghold, obviously you're gonna want the Power Boon and the Defensive Boon. If we want to look at the powers very quickly, we are using Asheril Seal as our main at will, followed by Blessing of Battle, which is a buff to your teammates. You want to sporadically cast Blessing of Battle on the mobs. And then as far as our encounters go, we are using Healing Word, which I have, gone over in the actual build video. And if you look at the patch notes for PC, I do believe this is actually getting nerfed. This isn't going to work like the way it is right now, so it's not going to be super overpowered anymore. But yeah, just to, prove all the naysayers wrong, that this was definitely broken. This was given way more AP than it should. That's why it's getting nerfed. If you look at the patch notes, it says, Gift of Haste is getting changed, where some encounter powers won't be able to stack the AP regeneration anymore. That's what they're talking about. They're nerfing Healing Word, so I guess they were aware of it. Boo-hoo, it's going to be over. The DC is getting a lot of changes, guys. A lot of changes I like, and then there's some changes I don't like. I agree with this being, nerfed, as it was super overpowered. You guys didn't want to believe me, but, it was super overpowered. You could take your party's AP from 0 to 100 in, 2 casts. So, hey, you didn't want to take my advice. If you're on console, you can still use it for until we get the DC changes. If you're on PC, sorry about your luck. Once that change does go live, I don't know what we're going to do. We're going to have to do some testing and see what happens. You can use Chains of Blazing Light when you're soloing or whatnot. I don't personally use it while I'm in dungeons. I do use it while I'm in, just soloing for the damage, obviously. And then, of course, Break the Spirit and Divine Glow is going to be the other two encounters for your buff debuff rotations, etc. Your personals, since we're down here, Hastening Light is a must. Every time you cast a daily power, your party's recharge time is going to be -4 seconds. So their powers are going to get a cooldown of 4 seconds. So if they have, if they just cast one of their powers that has an 8 second cooldown, you cast a daily, it's going to cut down to 4 seconds. You have to have it for end game. The more DPS your party's putting out, the better. Obviously, the faster you're going to mow through things. Now, I'm also using Holy Fervor, which is just AP gain. Now, I don't necessarily have to use Holy Fervor anymore because my AP gain is just ridiculous already. You can switch to Divine Fortune if your AP gain is already high. That way, you will be getting more Divinity faster, so you can spam your own buff debuffs out there. I don't have 4 out of 4 out of it yet. Like I said, my cleric still work in progress. Still need a lot of power points on this guy. So that'll be up to you. If you need the AP gain, Holy Fervor. If you need Divinity faster, Divine Fortune. And then, of course, our dailies is going to be, Hallowed Ground, which currently we don't use. But after the changes, I'm sure we're going to start using it off and on in between AA casts. And then, of course, the AA, Anointed Army. Now it is getting changed, it's not going to be 100% invulnerability when cast on teammates anymore. The power share is getting cut down to 33%. It's all in the patch notes for PC. I'll probably do a video just on the DC patch notes eventually here. That's going to wrap it up for the powers. I just wanted to go through very quickly. I didn't really have to. That was going over on the video as well. Very quickly, let's look at companions. Companions don't really matter, to be honest, on your DC. You can basically use whatever floats your boat. If you're a healing DC, then you want, companions that have outgoing healing bonus. Buff debuff DCs, you really don't matter. DPS, well, if you want to be a DPS DC, then you're going to want DPS companions for the most part. But best in slot for a buff debuff DC is probably going to be the Harper Bard, just for the added debuff that the Harper Bar brings to the table. However, the Lilind is a very good option, and that's just because that it does have three ring slots. Once the console does get Mod 11 and we get Illusionist Gambit, and you'll have more access to, you know, obvious more companion gear, there'll be more options available. So if you do have a Harper Bard, you'll be able to gear him out a little better. However, right now, the Lilind is very suitable for me. It has the three offensive slots, which don't really matter, because it doesn't matter how high your power is on your bonding companion, but we do have three rank 12 bondings, and then we got this little plus 5 ambush, plus 5 vision, and plus 5 vision. Obviously, we don't care about the statistics on the rings themselves. What we care about is the double offensive slots, and as you can see, we have 6 rank 12 silvers. You want to stack as much recovery on your bonding companion as possible. So as you can see, my recovery on my companion is like almost 4,700, which is ridiculous. The amount of AP gain that I have and the recharge speed is just, it's, you can't beat it. You really can't. So that's going to be up to you guys. If you want to do something like this until the Mod 11 update comes out, then fine. Even when the Mod 11 update comes out, Underdark rings aren't going to be working, but we don't care about the effects. We just care about the offensive slots. And then you can have an Owlbear if you so choose. The Owlbear, you know, does work with the DC. It's just for when you're soloing to do a little more DPS, because obviously my crit is nowhere. My crit is non-existent. So anytime I cast a spell, I'm going to do more damage just because of the Owlbear. Obviously, I don't have it upgraded yet. This will go up to 50% at Epic. Then I'm using an Aaron, yes, which is just a filler because, like I said, don't really need anything. I could put an outgoing healing companion here if I so choose. And then we have 2 AP gain ones, which aren't upgraded yet either, but they're each 1%. It's the Ice Sprite and the Flame Sprite. And they will go up to, I think, like 2 or 3%. I think 3% is the max they go for AP gain. But like I said, AP gain, do I really need any more? I'm already to the point where it's overkill, you know? Let's move on to the mounts. If you can get the 4K legendary mount, that's what you're going to want to go with. I currently obviously just have the 2K one. But yeah, the 4K mount power, equip power, is definitely what you're going to want. If we take a look at the insignia bonuses, we're going to go with Shepherd's Devotion, which means, you know, you're going to give your teammates a buff every time you use your daily, which is going to be, you know, defense, deflect, and movement speed. Artificer's Persuasion and Artificer's Influence. Obviously, it's going to, you know, you're going to gain recovery, an AP gain, and movement whenever you use an artifact. So every time you pop your DC sigil, your recovery is going to go even higher, basically. Gladiator's Guile is just for movement speed while we're in dungeons, because there's really nothing else to really put here. If you want to use Wondrous Fortune, if you still need refinement points or whatever the case may be, this is basically a free spot. The other four are pretty much, you know, necessary for this current build. But this slot, you can basically put whatever you want. Like, I choose just to have the movement speed, obviously. And then finally, definitely Assassin's Covenant. Takes, you know, 10% of your defense, deflection, and lifesteal, and then adds it to your power, which is necessary. As this build and as a buff debuff DC, you're going to want to stack as much power as you possibly can. And to wrap it up, we are going to go over the items. Now, what we're going to do here is, you know, like I said, my personal preference. I'm not going for relic gear on this character, even though some of the relic pieces I don't really necessarily would want anywhere. We will compare. So for your helmet, your Harl's Gaze, just strictly for the power, obviously, you know, almost 2,200 power. The Life Silk Spinneret is decent just because it does have the almost 1,500 power, 1,500 recovery. This is one that I'm kind of indifferent on. Yes, it almost does have 3K power. However, when you use your AA, this will nullify it, okay? This puts a DOT on you. So on daily use, you lose 25% of your hit points over 10 seconds as bleed. So yeah, it takes away your AA right away. Every time you pop AA, your teammates are going to get it, but you personally are basically not going to get it. So for endgame material like Fangbreaker or MSVA, I would be very cautious on using these. I mean, yes, the power on them is, you know, unmatched. Nothing else in the game has that much power. And like I said, as a DC, you want to stack as much power on your character as possible for the power share. So I'm kind of indifferent. Like, even when I'm doing, like, Epic Temper of the Spiders, and I'm casting AA, well, if one of those spiders hit me because they have, you know, 100% combat advantage, they will kill me, even if I just pop AA. Now, there is, if you do have cleanse, sometimes you can't insta-cleanse yourself. The bleed damage is a DOT, so it can be cleansed, but it's not 100%. It doesn't happen all the time. Now, if you're running two DCs in your group, that's a different story, because you're going to rely on the other DC's AA to keep you alive, but you're still casting AA for everyone else. So, I mean, if you run two DCs, this is very doable. If you're the only DC in the group, that's going to be personal preference and up to you. If you want to use those survivor's wraps for the power, then okay. If you want to use the relic, that's up to you. And then, unfortunately, the boots, there is no other choice right now other than by Dragonflight, just because of the power. Now, very quickly, if we... Well, who was PMing me? Who's going to make it into the video? Apparently, they want me to do FBI on my Warlock. Unfortunately, I cannot do that right now, as I am in the middle of the video. But shout out to Trash and Manchu. Anyway, if we look at the collections very quickly and go into the relic armor, as you can see, the vivified relic piece at the very bottom, if the changes to equipment, I'm going to lose over, you know, almost 1400 power if I change to the relic. Not interested in that, to be honest. The breastplate, I'm actually going to gain power. So, you know, I wouldn't mind getting the breastplate, I guess, as far as, you know, best in slot goes. Now the arms, like I said, I'm going to lose almost 1600 power, but my AA is going to properly function. That's going to be up to you guys. Like I said, I still choose to run the survivor's wraps just because I normally do run with two DCs and it doesn't really affect me too often. But late at night when I'm just randomly pugging dungeons and I go into something by myself, I do have to be cautious. I do have to be aware that things can hit me, even though I am casting AA, unfortunately. And then finally, the boots. Now, for the restoration relic boots, I do lose power, 138. But for the raid, I actually gain 263. So, I mean, if I were to, you know, replace two of those pieces of gear, I would probably get the chest plate, the restoration breastplate, because it is more power. And then obviously the boots will give me just slightly more power if I were to go for relic stuff. Like I said, I'm not really interested in going for relic stuff. I did it on one character. Don't really want to do it on two. So these are very good. Now for your reinforcement kits, which I don't have, obviously you want to stack more power. So, you know, you want a power kit on your head, armor, arms, and feet. I haven't put it on yet. I'm a slacker. If I did have reinforcement kits, this character would probably be 4K by now. If we do look at the enchantment, I'm currently using Terrain Descent and Elven Battle just for the 80% resistant to slows, immobilize, disables, and stuns. You can basically use whatever you want here. If you want to use a negation, fine. If you want to use a shadow clad, fine. If you want to use a soul forge, fine. Your armor enchantment is personal preference. There isn't nothing, you know, that's better than anything else. I just had this left over. I got it in a trade, so I figured, whatever, 80% resistance to slows, you know, whatever, it's fine. The weapons, we're using the elemental weapons, the burning set in particular. Because if you look here, it says, when using a daily power, there's a chance 25%, or there's a chance that 25% of your AP will be immediately restored. This tooltip is actually wrong. I don't know if they're ever going to change this tooltip, but it's a guarantee that you're going to get 25% of your AP restored. But it's like on the third cast, second or third cast of your daily. So every third cast of your daily, you're going to get 25% of your AP back. Unless it's the first time. So like, for instance, if you cast AA the first time, you're immediately going to get 25% back. And then by the third cast, you'll get another 25% back. So I don't know why the tooltip is wrong, but meh, it is what it is. Now, as far as your artifact powers, you're going to either want Blessing of Battle or Asheriel Seal. Mostly, probably Blessing of Battle just for the 12% increased damage. And then if we look at the icon here, you're going to want Hastening Light, because in the patch notes, they did say that this is going to be fixed. So if this works, they did change it slightly. However, this is going to work. Right now, it doesn't work. That's why I haven't gone through the hassle of trying to unlock it yet. But Hastening Light will also gift all allies with 10% of their AP. It will be, you know, fantastic. So every time you're casting your daily, you're also going to be given more AP. And then for your stat increase, it's most likely going to be AP gain, even though your AP gain is going to be through the roof already. You can't go with the stamina regain if you so choose. However, the AP gain, you know, you can't really pass it up, I guess. Let's move on to the right side. Basically, you want any necklace that actually has the AP gain on it by 4%. It doesn't matter which one you choose. I just have the Tiamat's Demise necklace. And then the belt, the same thing. It doesn't really matter. I went with the Greater Lathander's belt because it does have Wisdom and Charisma on it, as well as the Power Recovery Defense statistics. As like this one does have the Power Recovery Defense as well. Rings are going to be up to you. I'm currently using a Brutality plus 4 and a Rising Power plus 4. Just be aware that this doesn't affect your power share with these rings. Your power share only goes off your base power. So, for instance, that's why I'm telling you that there's no reason to stack power on your bonding companion, guys. It does not transfer. It used to a long time ago, and they changed it. That's why you want to stack as much power on your character as possible and all your recovery on your companion. But the rings won't add to your power share. They don't work either. And then, of course, shirt and pants, whatever's 145, no big deal there. Now, for offensive slots, obviously, power. Radiance. Every offensive slot you have, stack Radiant. That's as much power as you can possibly get. In your defensive slots, you want to slot Azores because we're using Assassin's Covenant, so it's going to, you know, add to your overall power. I forgot to go over the actual weapon enchant. Right now, I have a Transvorpal just because it's one of the things that I had left over from my Warlock because, you know, not going to spend too much money on this guy, so whatever. but best in slot, with the upcoming changes to enchantments, it's going to be up to you. It's going to be personal preference again. If you want to use a Trans Frost, that's fine. If you want to use a Trans Plague Fire, that's fine. Even if you want to use a Dread, because a lot of DPS aren't going to be using Dread anymore, you can put a Dread in here for the debuff features. You just have to keep in mind that the enchantments will not stack. So if you're running two DCs and you're both using Frost, they're not going to stack, unfortunately. Now, I don't expect everyone to run around with multiple Trans enchantments, but ideally, in the best situation and the best group composition, everybody wants to be using a different, and you know, weapon enchantment. You know, you want one DC to use a Frost. You want one DC to use a Plague. The tank could be using, you know, whatever the tank uses, Holy Avenger, for instance. And then the DPS one could be using, you know, whatever. Did you just see that, guys? Look at that. Manchu and I Am Trash just both pulled epics. What are they doing? They want to do FBI, and so I didn't acknowledge their presence, and now they're opening boxes. GG. Anyway. Okay. Anyway, last thing we need to go over is artifacts. Obviously, you're going to be using your Sigil of the Devoted, obviously, for the AP gain, and its power defense, which is nice. But yeah, can't really pass it up as your active artifact. I mean, you're basically just going to get your daily nonstop. Now, these three, we're going to go with the Symbol of the Fire, the Sigil of the Hunter, and the Symbol of Air. Now, all of these are power recovery. The Symbol of Fire is actually power recovery defense. Excuse me. Sigil of the Hunter is power recovery, and the Symbol of Air is power recovery. I don't know how many times I can say it, but you want to get as much power and recovery as possible. So, there are a few substitutes if you don't have a Hunter Ranger that's level 60 or you don't want a level 1. I believe the Heart of the Blue Dragon is power recovery, but there aren't that many options in the game that have power recovery. So you're definitely going to want to look into getting a Symbol of Fire, a Symbol of Air, and like I said, possibly the Heart of the Blue Dragon, I believe, is power recovery. Or you can go the free route and get the free artifact and just level a Hunter Ranger up to 60. But that's going to be coming to the end of the video. I believe we've gone over everything. Okay, so for your necklace and your rings and your belt, I forgot to mention reinforcement kits, AP gain, obviously. AP gain on every character because there's no other viable option usually. So yeah, AP kits on your necklace, belt, and two rings. But yeah, like I said, that's going to wrap up the video. That's going to be the official build. I didn't mention with the weapons. Yeah, we're using the burning set right now, but mod 11, you're going to want to switch to the best in slot, which is going to be the new Fey weapons. They're basically the same as the burning set. They're just an upgraded version. They have a better bonus on them, more AP gain. Because I'm going to label this video as mod 11, because all this is going to work until the DC changes are officially launched on console. So for right now, that's my current setup. If you want to see what my statistics look like, let's jump down here, see if we can get some stuff to proc. So right now, I'm at 38.1 base power. That's unbuffed. My crit doesn't matter. My recovery is 8.3 and my defense is 5.1. If we go down here, my recharge speed just standing is 56%. And my AP gain is 74% already. So, like I said, ridiculous amount of AP gain. Apparently, everybody wants me today. Like, holy Moses. They want me to play Smite. They want me to play Neverwinter. Jeez Louise. Anyway. But so, I want you guys to look at my power and my recovery when I pop all of this stuff. If I can get it to pop all at once. Let's take a power potion and see what we're at. I don't use very many food or potions on this guy. So I'm at 39, which I've hit 40 before self-buff, so I don't know why it's a little less right now. But yeah, 40k power unbuffed is pretty good. It would be 40k very easily if I had the reinforcement kits on. Okay, so let's see what we can do here. Let's pop this. Pop the companion. Pop this. Pop this. Oh gosh. There you go. 138, and I believe my recovery was actually even higher than that. 37k right now. We'll try it again here real quick. We'll wait until our artifact comes down. 42 seconds, guys. But so right now, just with my bonding companion, my recovery is 24,000. Almost 25,000. That's just with my bonding companion, guys. That's not including Artificer's persuasion or Artificer's influence was adds even more. I think as you saw briefly, it was like 37k or something, which is just outrageous. Like, look at my recharge speed, 124%. My AP gain is 62%. It's just unbelievable amount, you know. If we scroll down here, so actually my recharge speed is 139 and my AP is 120. So yeah, way overkill. Okay, so everything's up right now. I'm gonna try to do this as quickly as possible here. Yeah, so 3537 is what I was at. 135k power. Not bad, not bad. Let's see if I can get a double A off. Oh. No, I didn't get it. But yeah, so there you go, guys. That's going to be the video. If you have any questions, comments, or whatever, you know, feel free to ask. I'm willing to discuss why I make the choices that I do, but this character, this build, this setup is definitely good. We'll say that. It's good. I don't want to make assumptions or say what other DCs are running in the game. So whatever you want to do, it's up to you guys. But yeah, that's going to wrap it up for the DC build. Once the changes come to console, we'll be toying around with stuff. Divine Oracle is going to come back into play, guys. It really is. Terrifying Insight is going to get put into play with its buff and everything. So we're going to be doing a lot of testing with the DC in the future here in the next couple months. But for right now, this is good, solid build, good, solid guide. We'll see you in the next video, guys.